The events of the past couple days have been so dire that I didn't even write a script, so sorry if I sound a little awkward. And this is a location also known as my dining room, which I haven't used before. I'm going to use it now and see if it sounds good. If it doesn't, then that sucks. Tune in next time. But if you don't mind, and you want to know my whole opinion about this, that was their original deal. And Tom Holland had 5 movies. He was in 1 Captain America movie, 2 Avengers movies, and 2 movies of his own. And now that all of those movies are made, they needed to make a new deal, because this was a win-win situation for both of them, where Disney could have Spider-Man in their movies, and Sony would know that Marvel would make something good with Spider-Man. So it was naturally, both of them really wanted this, and a lot of people, including myself, like the Disney Spider-Man movies. A lot of people don't, but whatever, that's not important. So they were going to renegotiate. And Disney wanted to put in 50% of the money for each movie, and they would get 50% of the profits, and the same with Sony. And of course, Sony, I'm pretty sure, somebody fact check this, I'm pretty sure that Sony would still deal with the marketing for each of these movies as they have with the other Spider-Man movies, and Disney would still have all of the merchandise rights. And since Sony is a company with a brain, they decided no, because Spider-Man is their biggest property, and they're not going to let some other company take half. Right. So, that's the situation. Oh, also, Hulk is similar to what Spider-Man's deal is now, where Universal and Marvel Studios both collaborate, and basically Universal lets Marvel use the Hulk. Because Universal owns the rights to the Hulk for the films. Each of the companies own the film rights. They don't own the rights to the character themselves. So Marvel has always owned Spider-Man the character, and the X-Men, and the Hulk, and Fantastic Four, and Daredevil, and everybody. But the film rights have been elsewhere. And the TV rights for everybody is really mixed. But now, pretty much everybody is back at Marvel, except for now Spider-Man is in a weird state of limbo. And the X-Men are back with Marvel because Disney bought Fox, which owned the rights to the X-Men, so now they can just switch them over, and the X-Men can be in the MCU, no problem, but they're not yet, so, you know, whatever. Same with the Fantastic Four. So, nobody knows what's going on with Spider-Man right now. Now, as I speak, there could be new developments. I haven't checked Twitter since yesterday. It's been a very busy day on Twitter. Here's my thing. If you want to find out, if you want to follow me, please do. So, this video is titled, I don't know yet, but it's about Disney's evil. I believe that this is entirely Disney's fault for everything that's going on with Spider-Man, because, one, they are known to buy everything. And I'm going to link you I think it's Howard Stern part where, with Quentin Tarantino, and he describes how Disney does a lot of shady stuff, alright? And look at the poor copyright system. Look up the Mickey Mouse effect on Google, and you'll find out all the stuff that they did to the copyright system. And just because, basically, everybody, most people, are immediately blaming Sony for this because of how they messed up previous iterations of Spider-Man. Which makes sense. I mean, they've done it before. They've messed up 2 Spider-Man 3s before, so it would make sense that they did it again. But I think this is entirely on Disney for not backing down. And now that they haven't, they don't have Spider-Man anymore, so, I mean, it feels pretty good to have them have a lose. However, we lose too, because now Spider-Man is in a weird limbo, where either we're going to get another live-action reboot, or everything's going to go back to normal, where Tom Holland is going to continue as Spider-Man in the MCU, but also Tom Holland is signed up for a new contract with two other Spider-Man movies, just with Sony. So I don't know what's going on with that, whether they're going to make two more Tom Holland movies that ignore the MCU, which is pretty strange because of how integral the MCU was to Tom Holland Spider-Man movies. I don't know what's going on, but we'll have to wait and see. And I guess I'll see you next time. I might have another video on all of Disney's other things that I disapprove of, especially the live-action remakes. I absolutely despise them, and I was going to make one, but I wanted it out before The Lion King came out, and it came out before I made the video. But I want you to know, do not see any more live-action remakes. They are just terrible. But have a nice day.